This was the motivation for coming up with this abstraction of distributed shared memory in a cluster. The idea is that we want to give the illusion to the application programmer writing an explicitly parallel program that all of the memory that's in the entire cluster is shared. They're not physically shared, but the DSM library is going to give the illusion to the threads running on each one of these processors that all of this memory is shared, and therefore they have an easier transition path, for instance, from going from a sequential program or going from a program that they've written on an SMP to a program that runs on the cluster, because they don't have to think in terms of message passing, but they can think in terms of shared memory, sharing pointers across the entire cluster, and so on. Also, since we are providing a shared memory semantic in the DSM library for the application program, there is no need for marshaling and unmarshaling arguments that are being passed from one processor to another and so on. All of that is being handled by the fact that there is shared memory. So when you make a procedure call and that procedure call is touching some portion of memory that happens to be on a remote memory, that memory is going to magically become available to the thread that is making that procedure call. In other words, the DSM abstraction gives the same level of comfort to a programmer who is used to programming on a true shared memory machine when they move to a cluster, because they can use the same set of primitives like locks and barriers for synchronization and the pthread style of creating threads that will run on different nodes of the cluster. And that's the advantage of the DSM style of writing an explicitly parallel program.